We're celebrating Stephen Pavelsky today. He and Helen are the ones who gave us this. So we're going to do a few things. We're going to read some of Sparkky's work. We're going to do some songs and appreciate. Amen. And love. Okay? So to begin with here, I believe David's going to do a reading for us.
He's going to read his obituary.
Read the obituary. David Pavelsky.
Good afternoon, everybody. Some of you know me. The ones that really know me. Remember me as Monkey Boy from way back in the day. I was younger than half, you know, half the youngest here. I'm David, Sparky's youngest. It's great to see y'all. It's been a while. So I'm going to read the obituary today, okay? Stephen Barry Sparkky Pavelsky was born in the Bronx, New York on February 8th, 1952. His parents were Jacob and Dorothy Kaplan Pavelsky. Sparky's stay in New York was cut short when his mother contracted tuberculosis. When he was two, one of his aunts took his older sister, Annalie, and him until she recuperated. He attended schools in Hialeah, Florida, and Miami-Dade Community College. His sister, Annalie McLean, lives in Gainesville, Florida, with her husband, Chuck. Their grown daughters live there and in Chicago. He leaves his family, widow, my mom, Helen Kahn, and his sons, me.
Breathe.
My brother Douglas and John, who couldn't be here today. With wonderful memories of a loving life we'll live. He cherished his grandchildren. He was close to his grandchildren, Shannon Webb, she's here today. Joshua and Nathan, they're also here today. And we're celebrating his life this weekend. His sister, Rose, lives in St. Augustine with her husband, Gene, and their children. Steve was a true Renaissance man. He was an author, electrician, husband, father, grand and great-grandfather. Playwright, master mason, woodworker, former councilman, and mayor of Leggett. He is missed by many. And we remember in their hearts. Thank you all for coming.
Thank you, David.
So I may not get a chance to tell some tales on Sparkky since so many other people are going to be talking, but I would mention the first time I really got to spend a lot of time with Sparkky was up in Butch's yard there at the barn busting, and we giggled all night. You can imagine the scenario, and he dubbed me the King of Silly. And that's the title I wear proudly. Okay, Josh is going to read our eulogy. You ready, bud?
Good afternoon. Thank you for joining us today. I'm Josh, one of Sparky's grandsons.
We love you, Josh.
Today we are here to celebrate the life of a loved one, my hero in my eyes, my papa. My papa was multiple things. He was a mason, a writer, a magician, a lover, a fighter, and a cook, a creator, and so much more. He taught me a lot of things, from how to cooking up in the kitchen, standing up for what is right, and when needed to. He taught me how to write a little. He was always in my corner, like my bodyguard. He stood up for me unless I did something stupid or didn't do what I was asked to do. He was like a superhero, always there to fix an issue or save the day. Papa was everything you can ask for in a grandfather. I would say the best memory about him would have to be coming home and seeing him smile and To this day, I still look in the living room and look for his smile. He was loved by many, and he loved everyone equally. This is not for goodbye for now, Papa. Just right. This is not goodbye for now, Papa. This is forgotten.
Breathe.
It's okay, breathe. Baby.
It's okay.
Got this, buddy.
Josh, you can do it.
Nathan, finish it.
Nathan, you can finish it.
It's okay. You said something beautiful. You go ahead and speak, Nathan.
My grandfather was a man of wisdom, truth, and honor, loved by all he encountered. I didn't have much time to spend with him as many others have, but I had spent enough time in his presence growing up and to take that loving and caring soul he always had. We had our differences at times, but my grandfather would always have my back no matter what, and I would always have his. It's sad such a bright flame had been put out so early. I had never really got to say what I wanted to him before he passed. But I'm sure he knows, and I'm sure he's resting in a peace, resting peacefully. I loved him a lot. Can't wait to see him in another life.
Thank you, Nathan.
Hey guys, that was Josh and Nathan Pavelsky eulogizing their grandfather. Thank you guys so much for coming out today. Next up is my daughter Abby Davis, who has been playing music since the very first FCR. So she is definitely has grown up at this wonderful event that the Grand Pooh Bah and Pooh Bet have seen fit to give us. So we celebrate Sparkky with a Beatles song.
Places I remember all my life. Some have changed, some forever, not for better. Some have gone, but some remain. And these places are their moments with lovers and friends. I still can recall, some are dead and some are living in my life. I've loved them all. But of all these friends and lovers, there is no one compares with you. And these memories lose their meaning when I think of love as something new. And I know I will never lose affection for people and things that went before. And I know I'll always stop and think about them. In my life, I've loved you more. In my life, I love you more.
You guys,
I love you too.
So thinking about Sparkky, the first time I ever met Sparkky was at a reunion number 26, and he wasn't dressed in everyday normal apparel. He was wearing a banana costume.
He's a superhero.
So yeah, I didn't even meet Sparkky the first time. I met Captain Banana.
not a bad persona.
Needless to say, he made a big impression on me. And he was wonderful. He captured everything that was beautiful about the spirit of that event. Usually he never ceased to surprise me, even after the banana costume. He surprised me by making the best matzo ball soup I've ever had in my life.
Yes.
He also surprised me by discovering that he was an excellent woodworker, that he could mill wood, you know. I mean, the second or third, well, I had seen him many times, but the first or second FCR, I remember I saw him and he had wood chips sticking out of his legs. I'm like, Sparkky, back away from the wood mill. Anyway, he was just a man of many talents and always a man that would never fail to make you laugh. So today we're kind of free-flowing with this service, but if there's any pauses in between, just take some moments and share your fun Sparkky stories, because I know probably everybody here has one. So, well, let's see what's next. All right, so actually, speaking of that, we have Doug coming up next, and he's going to read a story that Sparkky wrote about the first FCR.
And then the fun began.
Oh, it's been a minute since I've been on stage. Well, hello, everybody.
Hi.
I'm Doug.
Hi, Doug.
I'm the middle child. Is this one working?
Yep.
You're just taller than I am.
Yeah, just a little bit. Well, I'm going to read a story about his first FCR, and it's pretty funny. Oh, my God. I lost my mind this Memorial weekend. I was standing in front of the stage at the Kirkland's Glen, listening to a band called The Shucks. My mind tried to slip away during Big Mama E and the Cool.
Good luck.
Again during Fathers and Sons and all the other nine rock and roll and blue grass ensembles. All of them playing for the pure joy of it. A chance to come and camp on 157 acres of pristine forest wetlands with an ancient swamp pond in the back. My friends and I built, y'all remember that, don't you?
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
My friends and I built the stage from trees felled by Hurricane Floyd in 99. Red oak, white oak, poplar, walnut, some of them as long as 70 feet, several hundred years old or older. All were lying on the ground, the outer setwood rotted away, leaving just a hard heart. About a sawmill, you should have heard that conversation. Honey, I want to buy a sawmill. A sawmill? What are you going to do with a sawmill?
Cut it off.
Saw wood. She thought I lost my mind then. But no, I hadn't yet. I lost it on Memorial weekend. So we built the stage, the kitchen, a bar, and a concrete pad for a foosball table. And the bands came and brought their families. Picture if you were teens, tweens, and infants playing frisbee, riding bikes, pulling each other around in little red wagons. I could have sworn I saw Norman Rockwell standing in the background creating a portrait of an American life. Smell the hot dogs and hamburgers cooking away on a 4-foot round grill sitting on top of a red brick mortarless fire pit. Smell the coleslaw and potato salad, the baked beans, chili and all sorts of condiments sitting on the hand-cut plank of a walnut that forms the countertop. On another plank are cakes of all shapes and flavors. Over there is a cake Miss Iris made using strawberry slurry instead of milk. To the left in the bench shadow of a pecan tree, Nathan pumps water while Shannon sticks her head in the flow. Steam rises from her ruddy cheeks as the ice-cold groundwater evaporates in the heat of the day. At dark, the woods were lit with candles and colorful lights. The occasional campfire punctuated the stark darkness of the magical wetlands, and children sat around with marshmallows falling off pointed sticks. At the stage, people were dancing and singing along to some of the finest musical groups ever assembled in the outdoor venue. I was in front, close and personal, the honor spot for the ones who made the Fishing Creek reunion happen. Then she started to sing. Was it an angel? Had I died and gone to heaven? No, the angelic voice belonged to Billy Carl, if I said the name correctly. As if I closed my eyes, Patsy Cline is on stage, no more than 5 feet from me, singing, I Go to Pieces. But I didn't close my eyes because Billy, is a treat to watch. So I lost my mind. And I was cheering so loudly with so much gusto, my throat began to ache. Oh my God, I lost my voice. You gotta love Sparky.
Yeah, you
gotta love it.
While we're getting ready here, I just want to remind you there's a guest book every year, so be sure to stop by and sign it if you will. And we're serving the beer that was brewed in honor of Sparky. It's Sparky's Coffee Chocolate Milk Stout, so be sure and try some from Double Barley. And we're going to do a Richard Thompson song for you now.
Yes.
Sparky really loved Richard Thompson.
Yes.
This old house is falling down around my ears. I'm drowning in a river of my tears. When all my will is gone, you hold me sway, and I need you at the dimming of the day. You pull me like the moon pulls on the tide. You know just where I keep my better side. What day have come to keep us far apart. Oh, a broken promise, oh, a broken heart. Now all the bonny birds have wheeled away, and I need you at the dimming of the day. Come the night, you're only what I want. Come the night, you could be my confidant. I see company. Oh, why don't you ease your worried mind with me? I'm living for the night we steal away, and I need you at the dimming. Yes, I need you at the dimming of the day.
All right, that was a little tough. Okay, Pam, can you come on up? We have a book here that Sparky wrote. He wrote more than one, but we only bought one today. It's Racing Plastic Pink Flamingos. And Pam was actually reading it again and selected a few passages. And Mike and I took the liberty of assigning readers. So Pam is first with Fuel and Epitaph.
Bless you. seems like before I start reading the words that Sparkky wrote, that I should say what a giant impact he had on me. I'm sure that every one of you who was in his company remembers it, whether you knew him well or not. I met him about the same time Emma did, maybe a year or two before, but he was dressed like a banana. And it dawned on me as his grandsons were talking about the superhero in him that, hey, Captain Banana is very much a superhero in my book. What stands out to me, though, is the way he loved. It was not common. And those of us who were able to feel that love reflected back on us, boy, what lucky souls. Uncommon. Thank you, Sparkky. So, not being able to gather with all of you right away after we got the news that he had passed, I got the books that he had given me, and I just read them all and thought about how fucking crazy he is, and I love the way that mind works and where it goes, and it is untethered, oh my. But one thing that stood out to me, again, was the way he loved, and it came through in his words, and in particular, how much he loved his wife. Oh my goodness, so many things he wrote were about his adoration of that woman that we know as Helen, the Grand Poobette. So I guess it's fitting that I'm gonna read something that he entitled Epitaph. Wonder why? Flowers cry, dew drops form and fall from petals stretched to catch the morning sun. No one knows its name, and so it cries. The tears that are falling today are of sheer joy and love and how lucky we are, and yay. It's my honor to read one more. Fuel. A poet's mind never sleeps, but dreams an everlasting dream of dipping from the well new words, to keep his lover in his arms, of pulling from the air new thoughts with which to fuel the fire. Sparkky, you fuel our fire, just like your name says.
Okay, we're going to have hear from some Wilsonage here.
Personally, want to say that it's an honor. honor and a privilege to have known Sparkky. Playing the FCRs, we kind of looked at it like we were playing for Helen Sparkky. And it's just an honor to know him.
He's a great man.
What he said.
Don't break it, you're both.
I'm not gonna touch that guitar.
You're an old woman named after my mother. An old man, another child has grown old. It dreams with thunder, lightning was desire. This old house would have burned down a long time ago. Make me an angel that flies from the country. Make me a poster of an old rodeo. Just give me one thing
too many Sparkky stories, but they usually wound up being fairly sparkly, so we all love Sparkky so much, and huge influence on all of our lives, one way or the other. So, yeah, thanks, y'all.
It's Alan, Kimmy, Jordan, and Jonathan Wilson. Thank you very much.
Amy!
Amy.
Amy hasn't been working hard enough this weekend, so we thought we'd have her come up and read. And as is appropriate.
Okay, love you, bye.
Okay, I don't really like doing this too much. Okay, is that better? Do I like it more now? All right, so I gotta say one quick thing about when I met Sparkky. He was not wearing the banana suit. He wore that the next day. But he was wearing the rainbow suspenders, which I think I'll always see him in my head, those suspenders. But he rolled through camp the first time I went to FCR, and he rolled through and he left a bottle of absinthe in his wake. And he warned everybody to not drink more than 2 shots. And I listened, because I'm a good girl. But I think we all remember that Jen didn't listen, and she had like 7. And then she is the reason for rule number 1 at FCR, and that is don't puke in the fire. All right, so I'm going to read one. It's the title story, I guess, for the book, Racing Plastic Pink Flamingos, one that he wrote for I guess, our parent party. Somebody put something in my drink, or maybe it was something I ate. It was good. What a trip. The Boogie, last outpost of the Woodstock Nation. Can't stop now. I'm on a mission. Boogie on, man. Boogie down. Boogie downtown. Boogie town. What time is it? 5 minutes to the Boogie. Would you like something to eat? Would you like, how about a fried or a smoked oyster? They're good on a cracker with cream cheese. Meet you at the bar. What a beautiful night. You can see the stars. It must be cocktail hour. I just saw someone dressed in a prom gown. Think it was a woman. Maybe not. Need another drink. Gotta find the ozone. I'm camped in the ozone, next to the dead zone. Or was it the Twilight Zone? Have to make my boogie rounds, 2,000 of my best friends to see. I feel fine. Haven't felt this good in hours. Not since 5 minutes to the Boogie. Or maybe it was yesterday morning, about 5 minutes to the Boogie. I'm not sure. But then again, it doesn't really matter, does it? Oh, yes, thank you. I would like to have one of those shrimp kebabs. Have you seen the ozone? Thought so. I'm headed in that direction. That woman is wearing a black bikini and leather chaps. She must be hot. She looks hot. I got the hots. Help, now I'm horny and I can't get up. I can hear the band from here. Good Lord, there's one of our pink flamingos. Far from the campsite, it must be headed for the bar. Have to turn him around. He's gonna get lost in the crowd. Stick him in the ground. Keep on walking. Look, there's another. Amazing, we put them in a line in front of the campsite. 10 minutes later, they were moving. Someone picks one up as they walk by and moves it a few feet. Everybody's got a favorite. I think the pink one's gonna win. Maybe the pink one. We'll have to see. We turn them around. Racing plastic pink flamingos. Anything goes. Everything goes. There it went. There it goes. It's gone. That's okay. I'll just fill it from the cooler. The never-ending cooler full of margaritas. Here at the campsite. Excuse me, the house. Our home for 3 days. And there's a cooler full. And here it comes. Ah, feels good. Help me, I'm horny and I can't get it up. Heard that one on the way back to the house. Thought it was funny.
So, Emily Smith and Davis Kennedy are going to do a song for us now.
Here and then I'm here and there and back again.
was it somebody that was playing his part? Whoever sings that.
We're gonna do this acoustic.
I wish I could have my love as kind as I could. I did my best. Hope I was good. I always wished I'd crossed a few more lines, but I always lived like there wasn't enough time. I left my footprints for you in the sand, couple of notes only you'll understand. I have one wish, someday you'll see how much your love has meant to me. So when I'm gone, throw me a party. You should dance as if I was there. Don't be sad, be broken hearted. Just send your voices up in the air. Sing my song and light up the sparklers. Tell my stories and drink all my wine. No, my love was just getting started when I'm gone. Throw me a party. Come on and throw me a party. Step outside with my ashes and wait for a beautiful wind underneath that foul yellow aspen. Toss me to the leaves and let the healing begin. So when I'm gone, throw me a party. You should dance as if I was there. Don't be sad or be broken hearted. Just send your voices up in the air. Sing my songs and light up the sparklers. Tell my stories and drink all my wine. Though my life was just getting started, when I'm gone, throw me a party. The hardest part is knowing that you'll miss me. Throw me a party.
Oh, put those onions away, damn you.
Yeah, I know.
I'm going to need IV fluids.
Man. Come on, Fred.
All right. Fred Starling, you're going to read. He surrounds me.
That was beautiful. Thank you.
Thank you.
You what? I'll try to get your attention. Good afternoon. Raise your hand if you love Sparkky. I don't have to hand up. Okay. First time I met Sparkky was right after the helicopter boogie. My first and last boogie. And Mike called and said, they're trying to get something going. He's got a good friend, has some good friends down in Leggett, North Carolina. I said, where? What's a Leggett? So I went to Leggett, and I met Sparkky and Helen, and I was instantly accepted. Part of the family.
Well, they're going to find some of
this is emotional for me because I'm talking to you. You know, I love you. Beauty surrounds me. Beauty surrounds me. It blossoms, swirls, and encompasses my senses. Day flowers are awakening to the morning sun. I open my eyes and see. My friend awakens. My lover stretches. Encompasses me. She opens herself to the morning sun. I open my eyes and see. The sun rises, climbing in the sky. Flowers open the petals. Their sweet fragrances waft. The colors blind me. The day grows on. Our love grows strong. My friend opens her heart and soul. Her fragrance assails me. Her love is blinding. Our day moves on. The fading sun sets. Petals wilt and fall to the ground. Night has come again. My friend grows on. She's a lighthouse. In the stormy dark, I open my eyes and see. Beauty surrounds me. So one of the first FCR bands we're lucky to have here with us, Fathers and Sons. Thank them for coming all the way from where they come from.
Yes.
And they're going to do a medley of their hit, Hey Sparkky.
So this song came along, I got to watch all the details since there's younger eyes and ears out here. But Sparkky, I remember meeting him. He is the first FCR we participated in, and this band came up. He had a bottle of that Lavaz absinthe, and the night didn't end too well for me and the other guys that were hanging out with Sparkky. I had no idea that little bottle was going to, you know, contain all that much fun and confusion and hurt the next morning. But anyway, he just welcomed us from the very beginning, his family, and he will be missed. I mean, he's a good man. All right, let me pull it together. You guys ready? The song is called Hey Sparkky. Me and the boys gonna gather up. up our toys, gonna play ourselves a tune or two. Out into the woods, down old 64, we moved all to play some simple songs for you. Down a dirty little road to a place that we don't know, pulled up and dumped a heavy load. Guitars, drums, fiddle and bass, we were in the right place, getting ready for good times to roll. People dancing, people playing, people yelling, people saying how sweet it is that you came by. And then we sang this song while they danced upon the lawn, singing, oh, we're some happy fools. Hey, Sparky, was that your name, Sparky? Hey, we gonna sing for you. We got rock and you got roll, we got heart and you got soul. Together we'll sing this snappy tune. Hey, Sparky, was that your name, Sparky? Hey, we gonna drink with you. $80 thrill's gonna give me the chills, and I know you're gonna petrify me too.
Anybody that wants to sing, but we want you to sing with us too. We're going to do I'll Fly Away.
Yes, everybody should sing along and continue to always remember Stephen Pavelsky, Sparky. Keep him in your heart every day, and if you do something that makes you think of him, you're probably doing something good. Or if you're not, hopefully you're here in the woods. I'm the videographer over here, too. If you have any messages that you would like to say, he'll be glad to video them and compile them with the video that he's going to do of the service today on YouTube for Helen and for the family to see. So we want to thank Sparky's family for sharing him with us. So, and thank you guys for your contributions today to make this service so beautiful, special for him. And everybody knows this song and sing along. Some glad morning when this life is over, I'll fly away to a home on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away. Hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away.
When the shadows of life have gone, I'll fly away. Like a bird from prison by the flown, I'll fly away. When we
just a few more weary days and then
I'll fly away
to a land where joy shall never end.
I'll fly away. Fathers and sons for driving from Fayetteville to play this song. Yes.